Talk about a little bit of, oh, look what I found. This is underneath the sewer in Dero territory, as you see the dead ballers there. And the wall that I just broke. And look what's in here. A praxis kit. A couple credit chips. Not a bad way to start this part. Hey everybody, it's 40ware. Welcome back to Deus Ex Human Revolution. We took care of the Cloak and Daggers side quest, and now there's only one thing left to do. That's to head back into Dero territory and, well, fly to Highland Park. I'm really happy about getting the praxis point. That helps me a lot. Because now I'm going to use it for the good of me. And in order to do this, I am going to put it to... I'll hold off on turns for right now. But I am going to put it to this. Carrying capacity. So now I can actually carry some more stuff. Maybe a new weapon. Maybe something more. Either way, I knew what I needed to. Now all I need to do is not get lost and find the way up. Because technically, after doing the Dero thing, you're supposed to just go immediately on the helicopter and then you'd fly to Highland Park straight to there. But of course, I had side quests I wanted to get done. So even though I killed two birds with one stone, in a way, in another way, I basically just prolonged it for myself. Which isn't a big deal, after all. I mean, when you take care of all the dangers once, you never have to take care of them again. So I don't have to worry about the frag mines over there. I don't have to worry about the ballers that are just standing right there. I don't have to worry about any of that.
Mr. Jensen, your limo has arrived. You ready to leave?
Yeah, let's go.
Great. Detroit Local. This is Serap Industries, Bravo Echo Echo 008. Continuing on.
We had another practice point for that. Ain't that awesome? See, that's the tip right there that means something. That's why if you have a pistol, the armor-piercing 10mm pistol, that's the exception to the rule. That's the equalizer. And now, it's time to fly to Highland Park. Get to the bottom of this. Or so we hope.
Richard. You got coordinates on that factory yet?
I was only able to pinpoint an approximate area, Jensen. So scout around and look for anything unusual. I'll keep monitoring the frequency in case it suddenly goes active.
Okay, the first thing to do here is we have these two Motor City bangers actually just standing around.
Yo. What's good, man?
And he's got good shit.
Might be a good idea.
Shit, son.
Special grenade pack? A gas and EMP grenade? Gas grenades are great. EMP grenades are great for machines.
I'll take a grenade.
Good choice.
Special upgrade is a leading software upgrade for the tranquilizer rifle or a crossbow. Leading software upgrade. Basically, it gives you a little thing that says if somebody's moving, it'll tell you where to aim so that you hit the target in stride. But
I could use.
Of course, I don't have anything like that. I don't have a crossbow, I don't have a tranquilizer rifle, and I don't have a shotgun. So.
I'm good for now.
All good, sir.
Also,
yo.
I could tell. You guys seen anything suspicious going down around here?
Suspicious ain't the word, man. All types of caravans moving in and out of here. They're going all out.
Who is they?
Well, that's the problem. These motherfuckers ain't consistent, for real. The feds were buying up all the land from the textile manufacturers until about a month ago. That's when some started going down in this bitch. Something real. What you call it before?
Suspicious.
Word, suspicious. Something real suspicious started happening. These spec ops moved into the factory and started running some sort of major operation. They picked off my brother for trying to set up shop in the area. Rest in peace, Big Rizzle.
Yeah, rip. These spec ops still around?
Yeah, no doubt. They got a patrol unit in the courtyard, and they got snipers on the roof and shit. Thing is, I saw some government vans lurking around, so it looks like they'd be moving the party somewhere else and making way for the feds once again.
Thanks.
All good. Anything else?
Nope, that's all I need.
All good.
So, that's what we're dealing with. We're dealing with special ops, and we're dealing with... we're dealing with the government. Again. So, yeah, fun for everybody, right? Anyway. This is really probably like the first really tough one where the game basically stresses stealth, whereas the other one you might have been able to get away with it before. This one is really, really driven on stealth. Any government facility you would think would be, logically. Hey, I remember you.
We've been compromised. Manderley was supposed to have that morgue locked down, but somebody got to the corpse before we did. We can still reconfigure. Track this Yahoo down.
It's too late for that. It's time to clean up.
But what about the Dutchman?
Eliminate him?
No loose ends, Barrett.
Make the call.
So those guys are here, huh? Interesting.
Mark, get out of sight, now.
Why, what's going on?
They're here. The mercs who killed Megan and her team.
Fuck!
I'm going in.
Okay. Now we're gonna start off, we're gonna have a bunch of these enemies just lying around, and they have this area pretty well congested. However, I'm going to want to be careful here because they're way too congested. Once there's three guys, just basically forget. Don't do anything. Just freeze until you have a chance to move. Turn, buddy. Turn. Good. Thank you. There's no doubt I'm going to have to off somebody at some point, but... Game. Don't give me a red reticle and say it's okay to shoot, and then have me do that. That gets you a giant screw you game.
Malik, get out of sight, now.
Why, what's going on?
They're here. The mercs who killed Megan and her team.
Fuck!
Either way, I'm definitely not equipped to fight those guys. And I think that's the whole intention of this game. That's why stealth is so important, is you're not basically equipped to take those guys out. Could also go that way and maybe try to break in there, but I always go around this way. Just personally, it's always been easier for me. Okay, no bullshit this time. Also, you gotta watch it with that heavy stuff because they'll hear that noise. They'll come a knocking if they hear that. Looks like I have no choice. Or they could just choose not to see me for doing that. That works too. Either way. There you go. Thank you. I'm taking this stuff. Shit. It was just the wind, buddy. It was just the wind. It was just the wind, and now you're not going to see me because I just went to a vent. Sometimes the unfortunate part is the thing leads you outside again, which is, you know, not what you want, but whatever. The whole idea about this game is to live and learn, so you tend not to worry too much. Bad guys up there for sure. Bad guys over there for sure. Hey, you. Oh, security hub. Definitely gotta jump in there. Don't think anybody will spot him. At least I hope not. And now I got a combat rifle, so now I got a decent weapon. It's all about picking your spots in this game. Ooh. Probably had everything to do with talking to Ezekiel Sanders. That's probably what it meant. And as you see, we can now shut down these two cameras. Not have to worry about cameras the rest for this particular area. That's always a good thing. Now, does that guarantee I'm never going to get spotted? Absolutely not. Obviously, you gotta...
Someone hiding over the... Stop! I see you!
Make sure shit like that doesn't happen to you. Also, that did a lot of damage. Oof. 85 damage from that. Also, that's a sniper, I think. No thanks. I'm gonna just hide now. Ooh, vent. Vent, I need that. Let me in. Game, let me in. Let me in. Thanks. Yeah, I'm not feeling up to fighting all those guys. Not bad, huh? A little unorthodox, but it's a very quick way to get to the elevator. And I could have just foregone all those enemies, including the sniper that was on the roof. Normally, I think you could also just pull right, go through that way, and be able to off some enemies that way, but vents are usually the quickest and easiest
Richard,
way to get around.
Batch me to Seraf. We may have a problem here.
Wonderful.
Adam, talk to me.
This factory, where the hacker's signal originated? It's got FEMA signs all over it. I think it's some kind of internment camp.
FEMA? That's impossible. Half of our contracts are government issue.
I know. But the soldiers who attacked us are here. And from the looks of it, they've got access to some pretty impressive equipment.
I better make some calls. Find out who's given the orders and get back to me.
By the way, it's a really nice thing that none of these guys see me coming down the elevator. After all, that would just suck horribly. But thankfully, it's only sending me down to the very bottom floor, and I don't have to worry about too much. That's not to say that the enemies I'm going to be facing here are going to be pushovers. Absolutely not. Hell, that box right there, that thing that looks like a box, that's not a box. That's actually a very deadly security robot. You don't want to fight that fucker. Trust me, you want to get the hell out of here ASAP. ASAP. Don't even think, just go. You can mind the cameras, by the way, it really doesn't matter. Just time it right and you'll be fine. But... Huh, it does work. I always know that shooting a camera does not work, but apparently the stun gun does. It's nice when you actually stop and actually read what you see. Or what the game is telling you. Because for a long time, I thought it was like anything you shot with was a bad idea. Shows what I know, right? What's a frag? Well, that could have been bad. That was a frag. Hey, buddy. Oof. That motherfucker means business. Sweetie, you guys mean business? You use a stun gun for no apparent reason. I know, right? It seems like the most illogical thing to do would just be use a stun gun to take care of an enemy, but... That's exactly what you're probably supposed to do. Okay, now we're definitely getting the hell out of here. Yes, I'm still here, but you're not gonna spot me. So I'm getting the hell out of here. Not for taking those things. I'd be stupid to stay there. Now over here, there should be some goodies. Now this one only has one thing, just one camera, but the key here is this door. Gives you access to all those delicious weapons. So if you wanted a shotgun, this would be what you do. If you want Typhoon ammo, you're gonna want that. If you want rockets, they're here too. Yes, there's freaking rockets here, I know, right? Unfortunately, rockets are only useful if there's an actual, you know, rocket weapon around. So, unfortunately without that, I'm kind of sunk. But, you know what? Concussion grenades I don't use ever. No, seriously, I don't use concussion grenades ever. Let's see. Got a bunch of frag mines. Those will be helpful. Whatever. Okay, two praxis to play with. Let's get the Casey. So anyway, that takes care of that little area. Pretty awesome, you can actually get that secret stash. We definitely don't want to go that way though. Oof, no way. Instead, the way we're going to want to go is down. The way to go is over here. You're going to head down. There should be one lone enemy nearby. Or none. None works too. But the key here is there's also a security hub. Oh, I don't need that. Alright. Well, they have a lot of this. Jeez. Did they ever teach them don't use the same password for everything? Although, how many people actually follow that? Probably not too many. There we go. Let's go through.
Who is it? Stay out there, goddammit. Time to unload!
I cannot shoot, apparently, to save my life today. Well, this sucks. Oh, that's right. Concussion grenades don't work, bitch. Well, I'm dead. Because I can't shoot straight now. Once I missed that first shot, that was the end of that. I might as well just died right then and there. You really cannot. You really have to make your shots count. That's part and parcel of, you know, stealth. It's kind of like stealth 101. You have to make your shots count. But if you really want to hack these things, obviously with passwords you still can. but, well, when you have a password, why not use it, right? Don't need these yet again. Okay. Alright, jackass. Let's do this again. Oh! I hope those guys don't see this. I know they're sort of like staying still, but...
Over there!
Oh shit, I didn't realize there was a second guy there. Damn it.
You bastard!
That's not gonna work. Yeah, shit. Totally did not see that second guy there. Attempt three at this. That turret will be very helpful if I can actually hack the security hub that connects to it. I do have that part, right? Oh no, I don't. Never mind. Never mind. I don't have it. But at least I can't disable it either, can I? Shit. No, you can't do any of that. That's right. There's a guy behind me too. Fuck. Fucking shit.
Lost the target. Hostile on the run.
Yes, hostile definitely on the run. Oh boy, this ain't good. Why am I having so much trouble with this? I have no idea. I surrender!
I know you're still here!
Yes, I am. And I don't want to use any of my grenades either because I need them for later on. Here. You stay down. You stay down and think about what you did.
Make the call.
I agree. You need to eat lead. You need to eat a lot of lead.
Die!
Well, this could have gone a lot better, but I think we got the job done at least.
End of the line. Die!
Oh, he's up there. Shit. A sniper rifle? Wow, what the hell is that guy doing here?
Die! Open wide! I know you're still here!
Yes, I am. You got me pinned down, buddy. Oh, Jesus!
On him!
Of course they would both come down at the same exact time, right? Coordinated perfectly. I see you in there.
Reloading.
Is he There's only a couple more of you guys. Okay, there's two of those guys there. Shit. This is not how you're supposed to tackle this. This is what happens when you get into a firefight. You have to pray that you're a good enough shot to get by. And if you're not, well, you won't be hanging around for very long. I'm sure somebody's gonna be looking at this, just shaking their head like, dude, what the hell are you doing? Normally I don't have a problem with this part. Normally I don't. I don't know why I'm having issues now, but I am. Anyway, the whole goal of what I was trying to do is get over here. Because I do have a code for this, so... By deactivating the lasers, I can go here, jump into here. Let's see where this vent leads. If it leads right near the star, I'm gonna freaking. That's exactly where it looked like it led. Right, led right near the start. Oh no, it didn't. It led. Oh. Well, that's where it led. That didn't accomplish anything.
What are you doing?
Oh, shut up. You guys are inconsequential. So, hectic battles aside, I like to say I'm making progress, but honestly, that was just bad. That was just really bad for my standards. Hopefully I won't have to deal with this again. Expect to be in a firefight, but not like this. Also, you can reset the alarm. Or you can hack it so that nobody can use it. Either way, it's up to you. Stops are good. Take any software you can find. If you find stop or nuke, always take it. It takes up almost no space. You can hold about, I think, like 50 of them per 50 of them a square, which is awesome. So basically, if you have a surplus of those things, you're doing something right. You want to hoard those things. And of course, you get a lot of them too through hacking. That's part of the that's part of why hacking might actually be a better option than passwords, even though passwords make it easier. If you hack, you actually get you can actually get some pretty nice rewards. Whereas if you use a password, you can't.
Jensen, that frequency we tracked just got a burst of activity. I think these guys might be pulling out.
So, yeah, for example,
I've kind of been getting that feeling. Any idea who's running
the
show?
If I do this, I may actually be able to benefit from something if I can get to these two.
But from what I can gather, the guy giving the orders is still a level below you.
Nice job, Richard. I'll find him.
Just like that. Using a quick stop will allow me to get to this quicker. Or I could just completely forget that that's not the way through. Oh well.
Access granted.
I'll take 75 credits. That's fine. So anyway, is there anything else good here? Not particularly, as far as I remember. Ooh, a hyperstim. That's good. Definitely could use the extra HP. Normally I don't care for that stuff, but anytime you get free HP, why wouldn't you take it, right? Nope. No consequence there. Hey, we're actually right near the end of the stage, if I remember right. Should be right near the boss of this area. And he's gonna be a doozy. Trust me on that point. I am not looking forward to fighting him. These bosses have tons of HP, and using your simple stick and move tactics are not going to work out. So you have to improvise partially. The nice thing about all these boss fights is they all have... Well, actually, not all of them. Most of them have a way for you to exploit the environment to your advantage. And this boss is one of those. So, what we're going to do is we're going to take care of him, and when we do, that'll end this part. This will be the last thing I do for this vid. Because right through that door, we will meet our first boss, Barrett. Here we go. Hello, you're big. You're very big.
Well, looky here. We got us a Boy Scout.
He must be the one who mucked up my operation at the morgue.
Get rid of him, Barrett.
Oh, that's gonna be a pleasure.
And he's augmented too. And if he's augmented, that means he has another weakness that you can exploit. You can EMP him. I'm serious. Augs are weak to EMP grenades. It doesn't kill them, but it at least keeps them weak. And gas grenades are nice too. But the key here is to look for these drums. And this will be the best way to inflict damage. Luke is talking about playing dirty. You're the one that's got a fucking grenade. All the grenades up the wazoo you're throwing around. Also helps that he's running right into my freaking gas. Or that was his gas. The majority of the damage I'm going to want to inflict will be from explosives. Although mines are acceptable as well. But, basically, I'm not very well equipped for this fight. I could be a lot better. But, being able to use gas grenades, EMP grenades, will always help. No, it's not enough, buddy. And, of course, there are new weapons. More weapons in this area if you need them, including a typhoon, which is nice. Oh yeah, I mentioned he's very powerful and will hurt you very quickly. Wow. Grenades are definitely the number one way, and of course explosives will help take care of Barrett. You really don't want to get into a firefight with the guy straight up without a few dirty tactics.
This Boy Scout's got a few questions.
Otherwise,
to ask.
The Boy Scout's gonna die really quickly.
The one who called you Barrett. Who is he? Why is FEMA sending you after Seraph Industries?
FEMA?
It's not FEMA.
You check, think FEMA?
Check the guy's uniform.
About some rinky-dink biotech corporation's company secrets.
Phone's ringing.
You got worse enemies than FEMA.
Yeah, like who?
Who?
Get to Shanghai. Hangsha Court Gardens. Penthouse. Tell him. Tell him. Tell him Barrett sent you straight to hell!
Jensen, what's going on down there? Those soldiers just sticks out like you wouldn't believe.
They see you?
No, I was flying dark in case it got hot. You all right?
I'm fine. Patch me to Seraph.
I'm getting you out of here first. Get to the LZ. I'll pick you up there.
Oh, jeez. Another phone call. Gotta have too many of these. So anyway, thank God we took care of Barrett, and now the place looks like a hellhole. I don't have any grenades, but that's okay. I specifically got that grenade pack specifically for Barrett. Because I knew that he'd be a gigantic pain in the ass. And yes, that is why I did not use grenades on any of the other enemies, because I had that same intention in mind for them too. Either way, this elevator will take us back up to the surface, and right near where the Motor City Bangers were. So, we don't have to worry about them. So you know what? Let's ride out of here, and that'll end this part.
You ready to get out of here, Jensen?
Hell yeah.
Yeah, take us back to Seraph Industries.
None too soon, if you ask me. Strap in and hold on!
I need to speak with you. Meet me in your office right away.
I'd love to, Francis, but I have to debrief Seraph first.
I suppose you could, or you could hear what I have to say and see if that doesn't change things. Pritchard out.
I wonder what Pritchard is implying there. Well, either way, we'll find out in the next part. See you guys then. 40 Warriors signing off.